Hello everyone, today we've chosen the rainforest, which is located in Umandao Global Buddhist Village. And again, here we are in a rousing evening, which is sunsetting. And another thing I want to say, each and every day by this moment in the evening, 5 to 6 around, people have lots of hopes about the rest after finishing their busy day schedule. But instead of resting, once they return home, they have to plan for the next day of their life. So are we resting in our life? Do we have a time to spend leisurely? And what is this competition we are dealt in? To talk this about this competition in our life, the restlessness of our life, today also we have our esteemed personality, Venerable Dhammasara Thero. You are warmly welcome today as well, Venerable
Thero.
Nice to have you, sir. Right. Venerable Sir, how do you explain this endless competition in our lives?
Right. As you mentioned in the preview, so everybody is running a rat race. Target, achievement or victory.
Yes.
Right. So initially, everybody is looking how to excel in their jobs. What about the next pay raise? What about the next promotion? What about the next vacation? How do I get another house? How do I get a cottage? How do I spend my retirement? It's a never-ending rat race.
Yes.
Based on victory. There is a nice story. This is about a Sri Lankan athlete. His name was Karunananda. He participated in the Tokyo Olympics. He ran. The race, most of the competitors finished the race, but he was still running. So he ran. Suddenly other events were also participating, but out of nowhere he enters the stadium and he's still running because you have to complete a lap at the end. Everybody in the audience is booing, shouting at him, ridiculing him. He's still running.
Yes.
He's running. He ran the entire lap and he finished the race. But at the end, when he was completing the race, everybody started cheering him. Everybody appreciated him. So Shahan, at the end of the race, a media person came to him and asked a question from him. All these people were shouting at you, ridiculing at you. You know you haven't won this race.
Yes.
But still you ran, right? Why did you do that? What was his answer? I never came to win this race. I just came to run.
Wise answer.
People in this world look for opportunities to win always. But here at Umandao, we don't look at opportunities to win. We do what is required to be done in a selfless nature, without maintaining our nature, our own identity. We work for others.
That means, Venerable Sir, for the betterment of the whole society.
Exactly.
Not to a particular person.
No. So the technique, Shahan, is when you work in a selfless manner, right, we don't maintain an identity of ourselves. So everybody in this world, Shahan, is looking always for opportunities to win. They want to win. But here at Umandao, our practice is totally different. We do what is required, what is necessary to be done, without maintaining our self-identity. That means selfless work ethic, working for the benefit of others. That is our teacher's teaching. That is what his practice is all about. We always think of others, work for their benefit. People cannot enjoy this life because of their selfish behavior. Because of their selfish behavior, they cannot enjoy. But they are always looking for opportunity to enjoy themselves. Our teacher's teaching is how to enjoy life, not to run away from life.
Yes.
But the art of doing that is selflessness.
Okay, Venerable Sir, may I add my opinion into your words? In addition, if someone is working to the betterment of whole society, not for my ego, then that person is already won. Is that so? Nothing to win.
Yes, there is no need to win.
That means you have finished your all works?
Yes.
For the insake of you?
Yes. If you have done everything what is needed to be done, but you do what is necessary to be done without the intention of winning. Do it which is because it is the requirement which is necessary to be done. Do it because of that. So then everything in the world is just a happening, not running behind targets and achieving targets. Running behind targets and achieving targets is a byproduct of selfishness.
Egoism.
So our practice, our teacher's teaching is always, the core is selfless practice. Working for the benefit of others, then only your personal identity, your profile gets destroyed. People talk about branded products. They like branded products. Branding is a big thing in this world.
Yes.
But our practice is a practice which we become a no-name brand.
Yes. That means, Venerable Sir, if I concern like this, so if we don't have a target, what is the motivation? We don't have motivation. Our life is tarnished, like I feel.
Right. Targets are there. Definitely, targets should be there. Without targets, how can this Umanda be built?
Yes.
Right? Targets are there.
The land of wonder.
Land of wonder, if you may say so.
Yes.
So targets are there. Targets should be there. But our over-reliance should be removed. Targets don't materialize all the time. Weather, nature, political situations, then pandemic effects, all could change our targets. But we have to work with a target. But accept the outcome. Then the world will become a nice place. But key is selfless practice.
That means we have to have a target by, but
yes,
we have to avoid the egoism behind the target.
Yeah, we have to have a target, work towards the target, but accept the outcome and know that you are not maintaining your ego when you are trying to achieve that. Then if you are basing yourself with your ego to achieve something, you're always running that race.
Yes.
Right?
That means we have target in our mind. We have both positive and negative outcome will be there down the line.
Yes.
We should be able to accept both the scenarios.
Yes, because it's the flow of events. We cannot predict what will happen, but we have to have the target and go for the goal, but accept whatever comes.
Right. When I consider my life so far, I have experienced many things in my life. Sometimes some of the targets I have won, some of the targets I have lost. So in these two scenarios, so what is this target? That means, for an example, we had examinations, we had our other life goals, we had to achieve those. But Venerable Sir, always our mind becomes restless because of this competition. Always we have to compare our life with others who is surrounding us, our neighbors, friends and all. So I think, according to my point of view, this competition is the point where we become restless. What's your concern here?
Yes, Shehan, competitiveness or going behind targets creates anger.
Yes.
Creates frustration. It also, competition fuels even love.
Yes.
Right? We have competition to love.
Yes.
And competition frustrates us because we get hatred with others also.
Yes.
Because of competition. Actually, Shehan, there are actually no people in this world to love or to hate. Only people are there to be associated. So, say for example, both of us, you are currently here. We are having this interview or discussion. We talk well, we have a cup of tea and we exit. I don't remember about you off and on. People need to associate, to have relationships only if they need to love or hate a person.
Right, that means, but we feel when we meet, we don't have any attachment. But at the other end, we are bosom friends. That feelings are there. I think what I feel is, whenever there is no attachment, then only the real relationship exists. Is that so?
It is true. Actually, the moment we meet is the moment we separate. But people rarely see this.
That is a wise statement. At the moment we meet, that is the moment
we exit. We remove ourselves from the relationship.
Right.
People rarely see this. So if we understand this from the bottom of our heart, everything that we do is under interpersonal relationships. It's just associationship for the occasion. We associate for that moment. We associate well. We have the feeling of friendship.
Yes.
But once we are done with this, we exit.
We have nothing to either love or hate.
Exactly.
Our mind is clear.
Yes.
And clean.
Yes. Then when that is there, it's very nice. You can enjoy the world to the fullest because there is no unnecessary baggage taken around.
There are no any limitations.
Yes.
But Venerable Sir, with this concept, can we spend a family life?
Of course, you can. But to a certain extent, which happens is once you practice this, if the other party is not compatible and the other party doesn't know your really
yes.
real thinking, you'll be a mismatch to the world.
Definitely.
Right? So even later on in my practice, also in my last stages in my lay life, yes, I felt that.
And there's another concern. This is my own experience. In our normal life, we tend to visit many places, school, universities, or trips, journeys, relations, we are visiting them. But each and every place, we have a burden inside. We are firing. That means we have a competition with our cousins, with our friends. We see their assets and we prepare our own competition to tally with them. But in case of this Umandava, whenever I step to this Umandava, there is no competition. That's why truly I am feeling really free. Venerable Sir, what is this? Why do we feel free in this land?
So in Umandava, all of us here have been practicing this path for quite a while. So here we have people who are running the race without targets.
That means, Venerable Sir, all of you are focusing to a common target.
Yes, what we are working for is a common target. The target, one mind concept. Though we have lot of minds, we are working to the common interest, common goal of this entire system. Entire system meaning the Umandava Global Buddhist Village.
Right.
So then, without nourishing, enriching our personality, we practice the selflessness.
Exactly.
So when we are selfless, then we come to the one thinking. Then, rather than satisfy
one heartbeat,
without nourishing our
soul.
What we do is we work for the benefit of others. Then the world becomes a better place. That is our teacher's teaching. And as you said, I invite all others to come have a look at Umandava, learn what you can learn, and look at the opportunity to get the experience of winning the race of life.
So that means in order to win the race of the life, we have to get rid of the competition. Then already we have won.
Exactly. Then once we remove ourselves from the competition, we are running, but truly speaking, we have stopped. So that is a good example that I remember is the story about Angulimala. In Gautam Buddha's time,
yes.
Angulimala, he was chasing after the Buddha. He was collecting
fingers of
a necklace made of fingers of people who he had killed.
Yes.
And so he had to collect, according to the story, only one finger. And he saw the Buddha and he was running behind the Buddha. Then the Buddha said something very wise. He said, "I have stopped, you stop." So that is something we can connect to our discussion.
The Buddha said opposite way. While he is running, he said that he has stopped.
Yes, while he was running, he said he has stopped. Meaning he has stopped running the race of continuous existence and he was inviting Angulimala to stop that race too. So because Angulimala had the wisdom, he was able to grasp it.
Right. That means that is not just a running, there is a deep philosophy behind.
Deep philosophy behind.
Right.
That.
All right, with that we are going to conclude our session today, and today also I highly appreciate your presence here, Venerable Sir, and I hope you got something about this discussion to make your life better. And see you next time. Thank you for tuning in. See you. Goodbye.